first name is Edmund, and my last name is Bertschinger. I work at MIT in Cambridge, Mass., right outside of Boston. This is my briefcase where I keep a laptop, of course, and papers. I should say, on my academic side, I'm a theoretical astrophysicist, so let's see what I've got about those things. A notebook. If you sometimes see an older man on an airplane flight scribbling away with all the equations in his notebook, that might be me doing some mathematical physics and astrophysics calculations. And then this, one of these charger doohickeys for your mobile devices. Of course, a notebook for writing down my thoughts. Some ties. I like to dress sharp. There was something I used last night. Oh yes, earplugs. My briefcase is packed with so many things I sometimes forget all what's in it. Yeah, not all astrophysicists carry these things, I suspect. Sunglasses, very important. Flashlight. I use this for emergencies or maybe for demonstrations. So I don't have it in my briefcase now, but sometimes I would have something like a diffraction screen, a grating for illustrating the spectrum of light. And it's really cool to look at the different colors of light produced by different types of lights. I use a gaming laptop, an Alienware laptop. I love the hardware. This is the only laptop that's readily available that has a lot of solid state memory for the hard drive in place of a disk drive, and has a lot of memory and good processor speed. So that's not everything, but that's almost everything. My briefcase suddenly weighs very little. I'm working on two main areas at the moment. The first one is on black holes. What I'm trying to do is explore, using Einstein's theory, as far as we can to figure out what a realistic black hole would look like in the middle. And it's hard. Not even this notebook full of equations has been able to crack that nut. A black hole is a region of very high, almost infinite density, surrounded by a border called an event horizon. Once you cross that border, you either have to fall into and be crushed by the center of the black hole, or maybe, we're not sure, you might be able to navigate through the black hole and come out to another universe.
How cool is that?
That is amazing. I'd love to know if that's really true. I really want to encourage young people to go into STEM. It is so exciting to work on these great cosmic questions. What's it like falling into a black hole? How did galaxies form? You can make your own questions up and answer them. Why are those stars there? Not just how. And that's been a draw for me and for many other people going into science. And it's a great draw for young people today to enter into STEM education.